Can you get the ticket without the VIP code? This is the description of EpiCrypt, an easy difficulty mobile challenge from Hack the Box and one of the steps of the Intro to Android Exploitation track. The challenge is pretty straightforward. It regards the process of reverse engineering an APK file, analyze its content, and finally patch it in order to bypass a VIP code checker. This challenge is very simple, so we can use it to focus on the basic aspects of analyzing and finding vulnerabilities on Android apps and how to reverse engineer and patch them in order to bypass their security measures. Before starting, if you enjoyed the video at any point or you find it interesting, please let me know it with a comment and dropping a like. If you are new here and you are interested in other content like this, I invite you to subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss any new content. Without going any further, let's jump in. So, let's start from the basic. What is an APK? APK stands for Android Package, and is nothing more than a signed archive file. This is the format that Google has decided to use to distribute and allow the installation of application on Android. And so, let's see what this application does. The challenge says to use Android version earlier to Android 10. In this case, I'm using an Android 6 because it's easier to set up, and I'm using Genymotion to emulate the device. Let's install the archive. The application does not present particular functionalities. It is only possible to enter a VIP code and check if it is correct. There's not much we can do at the moment, so let's see what's inside the APK. As I said before, APKs are archives, and like other existing archives such as .zip or .rar, also APKs files can be unzipped in order to retrieve their contents. Because APKs are signed, the simple process of unzipping them is not enough in order to be able to read the content of the archive. To do this, we need to use a tool that can successfully disassemble the archive into readable files. This tool is APK Tool, a tool for reverse engineering Android APK files. Thanks to APK Tool, we can disassemble the APK and be able to read all the files contained into. The Android manifest.xml is the file containing all the information about the app. Here are listed the package name, all the permissions the application requires, all the application's component, libraries in use, the minimum and the maximum API version where the application can run, and all other information widely discussed in the official documentation. The REST directory is the folder containing elements useful for the app to work, such as different languages, information about screen sizes, etc. The original meta-inf directory is the folder that contains the .mf files and the certificates used by the app. Finally, the smiley directory is where the disassembled application code is located. Reading smiley code, however, can be really tough. Smiley is the equivalent of assembly for Android, and it is very hard to manage. Luckily for us, there are different tools that can be used to obtain something easier to read. One method is to extract from the APK the class.dex file and then use a decompiler like dex2jar or JDX to decompile the Dalvik executable into a jar file, basically a Java archive containing Java code. Another way to obtain readable Java code is to use some automated disassembler and decompiler, like JDXGuy, in order to automate the process. The one I prefer is Bytecode Viewer, an all-in-one tool that accepts also APKs and decompile them using 6 different decompilers, including JDX. Okay, so now let's open our APK and inspect its source code. Referring to the Android manifest, let's take a look at the code contained within the application package. What the hell is this mess? It will be a pain finding the right spot where the VIP code is checked. In this case, it's better to use some sort of reference in order to immediately find the relevant portion of code. We can use the error code wrong VIP code to search for the checker function. Bingo! We find it. However, it seems that JDX, the compiler, is not able to decompile the corresponding bytecode. Let's see if the JDGuy decompiler can help us. Perfect! It worked! Now we can read the code and understand what it does exactly. Every time the button is pressed, the application generates an MD5 hash from the provided input and compares it with an hard-coded value. In case the two are the same, it decrypts and prints the flag. Otherwise, it prints the wrong VIP code error message. At first glance, I was thinking to brute force the hash and obtain the correct code. However, I had no luck, so I decided to generate my own patched APK using an hash generated by me and thus being able to successfully pass the VIP code checker. In order to patch an APK, it is necessary to modify the Smalley code directly. So I searched where the original code was used. I replaced it with the new one I just created early. And I used APK tool to rebuild everything into a new APK file. Sheesh, errors. I hate errors. Let's download the latest version of APK tool and hope it works. Good, we have our custom APK. However, we are not done yet. APK files need to be signed in order to be installed and executed on Android devices. Otherwise, they produce errors. We can use key tool to generate our key. And then we can use jar signer to sign the APK. Okay, now we are ready. Let's install the APK within the emulator and use our custom VIP code to obtain the flag. This was my solution for APK crypt. Do you use a different method to solve the challenge and obtain the flag? Let me know it in the comment section below. Having said that, thanks to everyone for watching this and see you soon in the next video. Ciao!